Okay, good day to everyone. So our topic for today is about the theories of polygraph, theory of polygraph examination, the parts of the instrument, and the polygraph examination proper. So first is, what is the theory of polygraph examination? It says here that the conscious mental effort of a mentally normal person to lie causes physiological changes. What are these physiological changes in the body? So we have the changes in blood pressures, okay, the breathing changes in our body, the inhalation and exhalation, and also with the sweating. Okay, that could be recorded by the polygraph instrument and diagnosed or evaluated by the polygraph examiner. So when we say conscious mental effort or the conscious mind, it involves all the things that you are currently aware and aware of and thinking about. So it is somewhat akin to a short-term memory, and it is limited in terms of capacity. So your awareness of yourself and the world around you are part of your consciousness. So when you are the subject in the polygraph examination, marami ka kasi nga iniisip, bakit kaya ako mag-undergo ng polygraph examination? So that is part of your mental consciousness or awareness. Okay? So in the polygraph examination, there are detachable part. Okay, of the polygraph instrument. First is we have the pneumograph 1 and 2. Okay. Finger electrode and the blood pressure cuff. Okay. So this is the pneumograph 1 and 2. We have the blood pressure cuff and we have the finger electrodes. These are the detachable part of the instrument. So now, so what are the built-in accessories of the polygraph instrument? So in the built-in accessories is we have the chemograph or chart driving mechanism, pen and inking system, so pneumograph section, cardio section, and the galvanograph section. So in the chemograph or chart driving mechanism, andito siya. So we have the chart roll arbor, idler roller, and the pen table paper guides, sprocket roller, cutter bar, off and on power switch, and the synchronous motor. While the pen and the inking system, andito siya. This is the reservoir of the ink. Okay, we have the capillary pen. Ito siya, yung mga pen from pneumograph 1 and 2, the galvanograph sensor, and the cardiograph sensor. So, we have also the pneumograph section. Andito siya, yung pneumograph 1 and pneumograph 2. Okay. The rubber gelos, beaded chains. Ito yung mga, dito mo ilalagay ang mga ito. Okay. So the cardio section, ito siya yung cardiograph section, which you can this is the auxiliary input. Okay, para makuha mo yung kanyang blood pressure. And the galvanograph section, dito mo inilalagay yung galvanograph sensor to para makuha mo yung sweating. Okay? So, the instrument itself, okay? So, in the polygraph examination, uses the polygraph instrument as the device used for recording the results. Okay, so hence all its component and accessories must be operational and functional. So the examiner should check the sensors or transducers attached to the body of the subject. So what are these sensors or transducers attached to the body of the subject? We have the pneumograph tube, we have the blood pressure cuff, and the finger electrode. So ito siya. These are the transducers or sensors attached to the body of the subject. Pneumograph 1 and 2, the blood pressure cuff, and the finger electrodes. Okay. So in the pneumograph tube, it is fastened on the subject chest and abdomen through the beaded chain. Okay. Ito. This is the pneumograph 1 and the pneumograph 2. It is fastened on the chest and the into the abdomen. And while the blood pressure cuff, the same type used by physicians that is fastened to the subject's bicep. Okay, but supposed to be the blood pressure cuff is attached to the left part. Bicep, bakit sa left part? Kasi dito mas malapit yung puso natin kaysa sa right. Okay. And the finger electrode, it is fastened to the index and ring finger. Bakit index and ring? Okay. Bakit kailangan may pagitan? Kasi ang finger electrodes, dumadaan ng kuryente dyan. Okay, baka magdikit yan, is magkakaroon siya ng shock. Okay. So now, what are the parts and function of the instrument? So the pen lifter raises or lowers pen to three position. Okay. Ito yung pen lifter natin. And the chart drive module, it propels the chart paper at the rate of 6 to 12 inches per minute, also known as the chemograph. Okay. The paper tear bar, andito siya sa dulo, pagtapos mo ng examination, kailangan punitin yung chart paper. Okay. Provides cutting edge for removal of charts. Okay. Mechanical pneumo module. Okay, recording part of the mechanical pneumo channel. Okay, galvanic skin reflex module, recording part of the GSR channel. Ito yung GSR pen natin, pneumograph pen 1 and 2, and the cardiograph pen. Okay. So yung mechanical cardio module, recording part of the mechanical cardio channel. Okay, and the chart drive roller lever, it lifts chart drive roller for paper changes and the chart removal. Okay. And ito na pneumograph 1 and 2. Okay. Ito yung kung saan nilalagay yung pneumograph 1 at pneumograph 2. Okay, the sensitivity control, ito yung sensitivity control. Okay. And the GSR and the another one is the cuff connection. So the auxiliary connection of cardio channel subject cuff tubing, and the pump connection for a hand pump used to inflate the subject cuff, and the centering control. Ito yung mga centering control ng pneumograph 1, pneumograph 2, the centering knob of galvanometer, and the cardiograph. Okay. Bakit anong silbi ng mga control nito? Okay. Kapag masyado nang kapag wala nang center, wala na sa center yung mga pen na yan, pwede mong i-adjust. Okay? Kasi kung lalo na itong yung GSR natin, okay, mahaba siya, the longest pen in the polygraph instrument. Baka magkaroon ng magkadikit ang mga yan. Okay, baka hindi tayo magkakaroon ng magandang tracing. Okay. And also the cardiolac lever. Okay, the cardiolac lever immobilizes mechanical cardio mechanism when not in use, and we have the vent, it performs a venting function of pneumatic system. So and also pneumograph 1, ayan, pneumograph cap, okay, and also we have the control mechanisms of the instrument. We have the resonance control. So the resonance control, it allows you to clear up and or make a better pattern when you have to match pulse pressures of the subjects. Okay. And the hand electrode, this is fastened to the hand by a stretch band. Its function is to make electrical contact with the subject. And the panel control, this is to allow the operator to control or adjust the operation of the galvanograph. Okay. So what are the other five important controls? Okay, we have the on and off switch. Ito yung power on and power off. Ayan. Subject's resistance control. And the reactivity control, the self-centered normal switch, and the self-centering mode. These are the five important controls. Okay. Yung on and off switch, power switch. Okay. It energizes the galvanograph section, and the subject resistance control it balances the galvo section and the skin resistance of the subject. Okay, the reactivity control, it adjusts the sensitivity of the galvo section. Ito siya. Okay, the sensitivity control of the galvanograph section. Okay, and the self-centered normal switch, it selects either mode of operation. Okay, and also we have the self-centering mode. The circuit electronically centers the pen itself after every excursion. So what are the controls of cardiosphygmograph section? We have the manual centering knob. Okay. Sa cardio is ito siya, yung manual centering knob natin, cardio section. Used to place cardio in its proper place on the chart. Okay, the vent bulb, it is used to left atmospheric pressure into the system and used to release the pressure of all parts of the pressure. And the resonance control, it is used to decrease the amplitude of the cardio tracing and used to sharpen the diacrotic nuts. So ito siya. Okay, so the control of the pneumograph section, we have the manual centering knob. It used to position the base line of the pneumo tracing on the paper upper heavy horizontal line. Ito yung mga centering knob natin. Centering knob ng pneumo 1, pneumo 2, the galvo and the cardio. Okay. And also the vent, with the vent down, the system is closed and non-operative. Okay, with the vent up, the system is open and ready for use. Okay, so what are the centering na? Okay, so ito yung part ng analog polygraph instrument. Okay. So next is the uses of the vent. Okay. The uses of the vent is to stop the pen between the test and to prevent possible tambour assembly, to prevent pen from possible jam by moving up or down in one place to of the chart paper, to stop the pen during the tube adjustment, to assist in gaining amplitude, and to let atmospheric enter into system. So these are the uses of vent. Okay. So next is the other considerations for an effective testing. Okay. So the considerations, okay, we have the instrument, the examiner, the subject, and the examination room. So we have already finished the instrument. Okay, so these are the consideration for an effective testing. Okay, so under this is the subject. Okay, so the following can be subjected for testing. Okay, so subject whose guilt is definite and reasonably certain. Okay, and the another one is emotional subject. This is for the subject. So because generally there are three types of subjects for a polygraph testing. We have the suspect, the victim, and the complainant. Suspect, the victim or complainant, and the witness. So these are the subjects of polygraph testing. So these are the subjects, okay, that can be subject for testing. Number two is a person who commit crimes in the heat of passion. Person whose offenses are accidental in nature, non-emotional offender. Person who commit crimes for financial gains, and the subject whose guilt is doubtful or uncertain. But remember that the basis, okay, all that has been said with regard to the utilization and accuracy of the polygraph technique is the matter of the examiner qualification and skills. Okay. So an examiner must be an intelligent person with a reasonably good educational background. So preferably a college degree. Okay. And he should have an intense interest in the work itself. Okay, a good practical understanding of human nature, and also a suitable personality traits which may be evident from his otherwise general ability to get along with people and to be well-liked by his friends and associates. Now, no amount of training or experience will overcome lack of this necessary qualification. Okay. So, a subject for the polygraph testing must be in good physical and mental condition before he or she may be submitted for examination. So there are groups of subjects who cannot be recognized or recommended, I should say, to undergo polygraph testing. So such as the persons who have extreme nervousness, persons who have physiological abnormalities, persons with mental abnormalities, unresponsive persons, pregnant women, and persons below 18 years of age. These are the subjects who cannot be recommended for polygraph testing. Okay, and the another one is another consideration for an effective testing is the condition of the examination room. So the examination room is importantly considered for effective polygraph testing. So the condition of the room, okay, must be as follows. So the lie detector test should be conducted in a quiet private room di maingay. Okay, armed with none of unusual police surroundings and with no distraction within the subject's view. Okay, walang nakaka-distract sa subjects ninyo, walang mga paintings, walang mga baka may mga Playboy paintings pa diyan, okay? So lahat ng nakaka-distract sa subject's view ay dapat wala diyan sa polygraph examination room. Okay, a room without any windows at all. Okay? Walang mga bintana. And the interrogation room should contain no ornaments. Yan. Walang mga palamuti. Pictures and other objects which would distract the attention of the persons being tested or interviewed. Okay. So, another one is a room free from noise. Hindi maingay. Okay, such as ringing of telephone or other conversation of persons outside the examination room and the presence of other officers or other spectators in the room is may produce disturbances and distractions, okay, which will interfere with satisfactory diagnosis of deception. So dapat walang mga police officers sa loob ng examination room, only the subject and the polygraph examiner. So, and also adequate ventilation is needed for with the comfortable temperature. So, if a glass window is needed for this purpose, it should not be installed facing the subject. So, dapat kung kailangan ng salamin, hindi siya dapat nasa harap ng subject. Okay. And the lighting should be not be excessive. So, there should be an observation room adjacent to the examination room. Eh, meron ding dapat observation na room katabi ng polygraph examination na room. Okay? Kagaya ng sa psychology laboratories. So, kailangan dito ng tinatawag nating one-way mirror or a panel of glass chemically treated so as to permit someone from the observation. Parang mga tinted glass without being seen and must be installed on the wall in between the rooms of the subject. Okay, that may be viewed from the observation room by the co-examiners for observable behavior symptoms relevant to the issue of truthfulness or deception. Okay, makikita niyo dito meron siyang one-way mirror. Okay. Meron nga din siyang camera. Okay? If practicable, the examination room should be equipped with hidden microphone. So that persons in the observation room may hear the questioning as well as witness what takes place in the examination room. So only those persons who have relevant purpose and or interest to the case or in the polygraph technique should be permitted to access the observation room. Okay. So moreover, there are additional advantages to an observation room. So there are other considerations in order to conduct a satisfactory lie detector test. Like this one, it is advisable for the examiner to obtain from the investigator's interest in the case all the available facts and the circumstances forming the basis of accusation or suspicion, okay, directed against the person to be examined. Okay. So what is the duration? What is the usual duration of polygraph testing? So polygraph examination normally takes from 1 to 3 hours, but depending on the purpose of the examination as well as the subject's attitude and any other factors that cause lengthy examination. So the examination sometimes may be very short due to the confession of the subject during the process of the test. Or maybe prolonged when the examiner seeks to resolve inconsistent or inconclusive patterns of responses. Okay. The actual questioning may be the actual questioning aspect of the examination which may be repeated 3 to 4 times and last no longer than a few minutes for each questions. Okay. Limits may be set in some cases because the blood pressure cuff can be inflated for 10 to 12 minutes, causing the subject undue discomfort. Okay. So what are the procedures followed in polygraph testing? So there are several phases to follow in polygraph examination. Okay. First is the preliminary preparation, which is the phase one. Okay. In this stage is the initial interview with the investigator handling the case or a person requesting it. So the group involved in this stage are the victim or the complainant, the suspects, and the witnesses. So this stage includes obtaining and evaluation of facts, determining areas the subject needs to be asked. Okay, and the investigator must furnish the examiner of the following documents. Okay, the sworn statement of the suspect, the witnesses, the victim or complainant, okay, incident or spot report, background investigation of the subject, of the suspect, witnesses, and the victims or complainants, the rough sketch or pictures of the crime scene, and the other facts such as a specific article and an exact amount of money stolen, the peculiar aspect of the offense, okay, or any strange set, the exact time of the offense was committed, okay, the known facts about the suspect action or movement, okay, the facts indicating any connection between the suspect's victim and witnesses, the exact type of weapon, tool, or firearms used, a result of laboratory test, and the unpublished facts of the offense known only by the victim, suspect, and the investigator. Okay. So these are the facts that the investigator that may be given to the polygraph examiner. Bakit? Kasi kailangan ng polygraph examiner na malaman lahat ito para sa pagbubuo, for the construction of questions. Okay. So the preliminary observations is the behavioral observation of the subjects begin from the time he enters the reception rooms. So magsisimula na yung behavioral observation, okay, sa subject, okay, from the time he enters the reception room until he is escorted into the examination room and must be recorded by the secretary or receptionist. Okay. So, hindi lang doon sa loob ng polygraph examination room ay no-observe yung subject. Pati sa reception, magsisimula sa reception hanggang doon sa pagpasok niya doon sa polygraph examination room. Okay, so what observed are the subject's general conduct or behavior while in the waiting room? Ano ba yung kinikilos niya noong nasa waiting room siya? Okay, so because this will give the examiner a clue or guide in the most effective handling of the subject, particularly with regard to this to his possible resentment toward the test or other attitudes, okay, which should be understood and alleviated before the actual administration of the test. So in addition to observations, it may be solicited from the investigator as to the suspect's behavior from notification of the test up to the arrival at the laboratory. Tatanungin mo rin sa investigator, ano ba yung behavior nito nung mapunta kayo dito sa opisina, okay, para mag-undergo siya ng polygraph examination. Okay? So, note should be made of any illogical or unreasonable objection to taking the test, such as the strange physical ailments, okay, that are sometimes advised by the subject in an attempt to avoid taking the test. Okay, that is the preliminary preparation. How about the pretest interview? So see, this is the stage of interview of the subject. So the primary purpose of the pretest interview is to prepare the subject or iko-condition mo yung subject for the test. So these are the consideration that should be taken during the pretest interview. Okay, the appraisal of the subject's constitutional rights, sabihin mo yung kanyang mga karapatan. Okay. Obtain the subject's consent to undergo polygraph test by signing the statement of consent, kasi you cannot oblige any person to undergo polygraph examination. Kailangan dito ng consent ng subject, at dapat kailangan mapapirma mo siya sa consent form. Okay. Na gusto niyang mag-undergo ng polygraph test. Okay. The taking of personal data of the subject, kukunin mo yung data ng subjects, okay? Tatanungin mo siya. Determining his or suitability as a subject, siya ba ay recommended for polygraph testing or not? Okay. Evaluating the psychological preparation of the subjects and informing the subject of his involvement with the case. Okay. So yun yung mga tinatanong ng isang polygraph examiner or sinasabi ng isang polygraph examiner in the pretest interview. So what are the rights, okay, of the subject? Yan yung basic natin, yung Miranda Doctrine, yung Miranda rights, the right to remain silent, okay, anything he or she may or anything he or she say may be used in favor or against him or her. Yan. So the right to have the lawyer of his or her own choice, and the right to refuse. Nakalagay diyan, right to refuse. Those are the rights of the persons, okay, na mag-undergo ng polygraph test. Kung ayaw niyang mag-patest, di so be it. Okay? So as earlier noted, subjects will not be scheduled for examination when they are obviously fatigued. Kung pagod na pagod yung subject mo, hindi mo pwedeng undergo ng polygraph examination. Okay. Or may sakit. Or may injury. Physically injured. Or na sumasakit yung katawan. Okay. Or obviously influenced by drugs. Or impaired by drugs or alcohol. And meron nakainom siya, yan. Okay? Or nagkaroon siya ng emotional trauma, hindi mo sila pwedeng i-test. Okay? So the examiner's interview with the subject prior to the test is considerable importance for both for the purpose of conditioning the subject for examination and also in order to provoke and observe helpful indication of guilt and innocence. Okay. So, in the polygraph examination, merong sinusunod na detailed outline sa pretest interview, okay, which has been found effective. Okay. So dito we assume that the subject has already been advised to the fact that he is not to be given a lie detector test. So first is the examiner enters the waiting room to request the subject to accompany him into the examination room. Okay, the greeting which the examiner extends should be cordial but firm. Yan. Babatiin mo naman yung subject if you are the polygraph examiner. So upon entering the examination room, the subject should be requested to sit down in a chair alongside the instrument. And immediately thereafter, the examiner should be proceed to the taking of the consent of the subject. Okay, then fill up the necessary data as in the interrogation log. And afterwards, inquire from the subject whether he has been on lie detector test before. Tanungin mo yung subject mo, nag-undergo ka na ba ng polygraph test? Okay, so no further comment should be made by the examiner, but he should listen carefully, okay, to whatever the subject himself may say. Okay, ayan mo lang siya na magsalita. If the subject has not told the purpose of his appearance in the testing laboratories, the examiner should explain that the lie detector test is desired of him as part of the investigation regarding the case. So much time should be spent in the preliminary interview, okay, as the circumstances are reasonably warrant. So yun yung gagawin mo bilang polygraph examiner doon sa pre-test interview. Okay, after that, after nag-sign ng consent, okay, andito tayo sa tinatawag na phase 3, the examination proper. Okay. So after the pre-test interview, the examiner should proceed to the placement or attachment na of the polygraph sensors. Okay, after pre-test, diyan na ilalagay mo na yung mga sensors or transducers. So the first na i-attach mo, na ilalagay mo sa katawan ng tao is yung pneumograph 1 and pneumograph 2. Okay? So the first to be attached is pneumograph 1 doon sa thoracic part sa taas. Susunod mo yung pneumograph 2 sa abdomen. Okay, followed by the cardiosphygmograph. Okay? And the galvanograph sensor. Okay? Kung ano yung nahuling inilagay mo, yun din ang unahin mong tatanggalin after the examination. Kung nahuling inilagay mo yung finger electrode, so ang unahin mong tanggalin after the examination is yung finger electrode sensor. Okay? So, review all the questions. Sa examination proper na is review all the questions with the subjects before the actual examination. Okay, the examiner should discourage any comments or statement by the subject. So the test instrument must be given to the subject upon completion of the necessary preliminary preparation. Okay. So the instrument is attached to the subject, okay, the blood pressure pulse cuff, okay, irarap mo siya sa kanyang upper arm or bicep, okay, especially dito sa left arm, upper left arm. Okay, bakit sa mas maganda sa upper left arm? Kasi diyan mas malapit yung puso natin. Okay? And the pneumograph tube adjusted around the chest. Yung pneumograph pa yung beaded chain supposed to be dapat 1 inch yung luwag. Okay, hindi kasi pwedeng mahigpit o kaya maluwag kasi hindi ka magkakaroon ng magandang tracing. Okay. The synchronous motor carrying the paper with the blood pressure pulse respiration recording are made is then set in motion. Okay. So, the motor being stymied and the paper moves along the rate of 6 to 12 inches per minute. So then 10 to 15 seconds after the instrument has been set in motion. Okay. So the ink filled pens of the instrument are permitted to make their blood pressure pulse respiration tracing before question are asked. So approximately 5 to 10 seconds after this instruction, first question is asked and then the other question is followed after or at the interval of 15 or 20 seconds or maybe 25 seconds. So hindi pwedeng sunod-sunod pag sunod-sunod mo yung tanong. So meron siyang pagitan na 15 to 20 seconds. So during this test, this subject is informed that he will be asked several questions which should be answered by either yes or no only. So ang mga tanong mo dapat is, sasabihin mo sa subject mo is dapat ang sagot niya lang is yes or no. Huwag siyang magpaliwanag. Only yes or no. So the question should be constructed. Okay? Na ang daan ang kasagutan lang ay yes or no. Huwag gagawa ng tanong na magpapaliwanag yung subject. And take note that if you are a polygraph examiner, the question may be written in advance of the test or in the course of the test during the intervals between the asking of each question. So the phraseology of the test question is an extremely important aspect of the test question. And the questions and the every word used in the question must be unambiguous or unequivocal or thoroughly understandable by the subject. So the question must be stated as simply as possible and with the complete avoidance of such double inquiries. Okay, for example, is did you shoot him and then run into the house? So hindi po pwede yung ganong mga tanong. Okay. So all questions must have only a single and unambiguous meaning. So avoid lengthy questions and also avoid legal terms. Ano yung mga legal terms such as rape, murder, imbecile, din yung mga iwasan sa tanong na yun. Okay. So for example, yung kanina is did you shoot him? Yun lang yung dapat na tanong. It is answerable by yes or no. Kasi pag dinagdagan mo pa ng and then run into the house, masyadong mahaba na yun. Okay? So, in the examination proper, it is important to limit the scope of question. So the relevant test question is used in the examination. It should be confined to a single case investigation. Okay. So the polygraph technique is not effective for stimulation testing regarding two or more unrelated occurrences. With all the gadget attached to the body of the suspect, the instrument will start running by applying pressure on the button. So the subject then will ask to answer the different types of question because we have different type of questions. We have the relevant, irrelevant, and the control question. So when we say irrelevant questions, these are the unleaded or immaterial questions. So these are questions which have no bearing to the case under investigation. For example, ng irrelevant question is, Juan Pedro ba ang pangalan mo? So that is irrelevant question. Wala namang kinalaman sa kaso. While the relevant questions, these are the leaded questions or material questions. So these are questions pertaining to the issue under investigation. So it is equally important to limit the number of relevant questions. Hindi naman masyadong marami yung relevant question. Okay, to avoid discomfort of the subject. So the relevant question must be very specific to obtain an accurate result. For example, ng relevant question. For example, ang kaso ay may nanakaw na iPad kay sa bahay ni Juan. So ano yung magiging relevant question mo doon? Okay. Okay, noong February 14, nasa loob ka ba ng bahay ni Juan? Okay, that is a relevant question. Okay. And the control question is, these are questions unrelated to the matter regarding or under investigation but are not similar, but are of similar nature, although less serious as compared to those relevant questions. So for example, ng control question is, mayroong kaso ng robbery sa isang bangko. Ngayon, ang pwede mong maitanong sa kanya sa control is, for the past 5 years or past 10 years, nasangkot ka na ba sa magnanakaw? Okay. So those are control question. So although yung kaso ay robbery ngayon, pero tinanong mo is, past 5 years pa to 10 years, nasangkot ka na ba sa mga or nasangkot ka na ba sa sangkrimen? Okay? So next is the post-test interview. Okay. So in the post-test interview, okay. So this is the stage, okay, that includes all consideration that bears on the examination. So this is done just after the instrument is turned off. Ito ay ginagawa lang pagkatapos na ng examination. Okay. So if the polygraph test result indicates deception, the examiner will then proceed to conduct a short investigation. Kapag mayroong kaduda-duda doon sa kanyang tracings, as an examiner, you will proceed to conduct a short interrogation to the subject. So why? Because the purpose of which is to obtain confession of the subject. So, however, if the polygraph indicates that the subject is innocent, so the examiner will just release the subject cordially and thanks him or her for his or her cooperation. So the purpose of further questioning after the test is to clarify the findings, okay? To learn if there are any other reasons for the subject responding to a relevant question other than the knowledge of the crime. And the other one is to obtain additional information, okay, and an admission for the law enforcement purposes if the result suggests deception. So this is the purpose of post-test interview. Okay. Ito yung napakalaga. Is the purpose of which is to obtain confession if there are signs of deception in the tracings of the subject. Okay. So that's all, and thank you.